Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. It is from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has blessed us with these 10 days, the season of goodness in which good deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than any other day. And the Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wal jihadu fi sabilillah, not even jihad in the way of Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, not even jihad in the way of Allah, illa rajulan kharaja bi nafsihi wa malihi thumma lam yarji' min dhalika bi shay, except for a man who goes out with his life and his wealth and he does not come back with either of them, yani he dies in the way of Allah. So all the good deeds are better than jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani all the good deeds in these 10 days are better than even jihad in the rest of the days of the year, subhanallah. Some ulama have mentioned that these 10 days as a whole are even better than the last 10 nights of Ramadan, as mentioned by Ibn Rajab in Lata'if al-Ma'arif, including Laylatul Qadr, because Laylatul Qadr is the greatest in virtue. Today in this short video, hopefully, we are going to shed some light on an ibadah that we all must do during these 10 days, an ibadah which is greatly virtuous, an ibadah which is very easy, yet we are neglectful of it. And most of us do not get the tawfiq to do this ibadah a lot. And this ibadah is the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to look at the tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has granted to a person, look at how much dhikr does he do, subhanallah. An ibadah as easy as dhikr and as virtuous as dhikr, yet very few people get the tawfiq to do it. It is enough as a virtue for dhikr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the slave who remembers him, who does his dhikr, that if he mentions me within himself, yani he mentions me alone, I mention him within myself. And if he remembers me amongst a group of people, I remember him and mention him amongst a group who are better than the group that he mentioned me amongst. Imagine that the Lord of the worlds is mentioning you by name, and it's not just any mention, rather it's a mention that is praiseworthy. So what an honor this is, and what a great virtue this is of dhikr. From the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made these 10 days virtuous, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made dhikr during these 10 days one of the best ibadahs. And it's the mercy of Allah because dhikr is an ibadah which is doable by everyone. Hajj, only a few people can do Hajj. Other ibadahs, few people can do it, few can't. Dhikr is something that the maximum number of people can do it. And it is the most virtuous of ibadahs during these 10 days. Amongst the evidences that indicate the virtue of this ibadah is a narration in Musnad al-Imami Ahmad, in which there is the addition that after the virtue that we mentioned in the beginning of the video, there is an addition to the hadith in which it says, so do lots of tahleel, يعني لا إله إلا الله, والتكبير, and Allahu Akbar, and tahmeed, يعني alhamdulillah. The authenticity of this hadith is questionable. However, the meaning of this hadith is sahih, wallahu alam. And that this is sahaba, the amal of the salaf, the actions of the salaf and the sahaba. All of this indicates and tells us that dhikr in particular is highly virtuous during these 10 days. One of the most important narrations is the narration of Ibn Umar and Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhuma that كان يخرجان إلى السوق يكبران فيكبر الناس بتكبيرهما. Al-Bukhari mentions in his Sahih معلقاً, as a معلق riwayah, that Abu Hurairah and Ibn Umar used to go out to the market and they used to say the takbir, and the people used to follow them in saying this takbir aloud. So this is the practice of the Salaf. Also, Yazid ibn Abi Ziyad has mentioned that he learned and he has memorized and he has seen, witnessed three of the Salaf, Mujahid, Sa'id ibn Jubair, and Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla. And he said these three or two of these three, he saw them and witnessed them saying takbir during these 10 days. So this is the practice of the Salaf, that they used to say takbir aloud during these 10 days. And takbir is the best form of dhikr during these 10 days, the most recommended form of dhikr during these 10 days. One of the most authentic authentic pattern of takbir that can be said is the one that has been mentioned by Abdul Razzaq in his Musannaf. He narrated that from Salman al-Farisi that he said, كبر الله, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar Kabira. This is the most authentic form of takbir narrated by the Sahaba. This chain of narration is the most authentic. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq to do lots of dhikr during these 10 days and do lots of ibadah during these 10 days and make the best use of these 10 virtuous days and this season of goodness. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wa sallallahumma wa sallim wa barik wa zid wa an'im ala sayyidina wa habibina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.